What's going on, y'all? Marvel Cross 316, back with another comic book flashback, and we are now looking at The Amazing Spider-Man Annual Number 2. This issue came out in September 1965, so right after issue number 28, this issue came out, and I think they came out simultaneously in that month. And as we look at the timeline here, I went on Google and looked it up. This issue comes out next, and next time we'll look at issue number 29. But right now, we have an exciting issue to look at today with The Amazing Spider-Man. As we see, Spider-Man's going to team up with none other than Doctor Strange. Doctor Strange is going to make an appearance here. So, it's an exciting stuff. And what's really unique about this is because Steve Ditko, who is the creator of Spider-Man, he's also the creator of Doctor Strange. And so, when you have Doctor Strange and Spider-Man in the same issue, drawn by the creator, the original artist, that's pretty cool. And so we're going to see a team up today between Spider-Man and Doctor Strange, and they're going to be taking on this guy right here, and this is Xandu. So pretty cool guy. He's right in the league with Doctor Strange. He's pretty much the evil version of Doctor Strange in a way. And you know, I don't know that much about Doctor Strange, but I think we're going to have a great time today just learning more about Doctor Strange and looking at Spider-Man and just the great team up that we have planned today. So as always, this is brought to you by Stan Lee, who wrote this issue, Steve Ditko, and Sam Rosen. Let's go ahead and get started. This is going to be a great annual to look at. It's originally 72 pages and it has three other stories. We're only going to be looking at this particular story for today. So we start out the story here today with Spider-Man just doing his casual thing, trying to patrol the city, see what's going on, and catch any litter bugs or jaywalkers. And he's just not finding any crime at all. He's kind of bored. He's not finding anything of interest to get into crime fighting. He's kind of bored. So he's just swinging around the city looking for something to do. And we see right below there's this bar, and it looks like there's a bar fight. And this guy in this green suit is walking into the bar, and all this commotion's going on, and these two big behemoth-looking dudes are just beating up everybody in their path. I mean, they're just unstoppable, savage bullies. And this guy right here, as you can tell, he looks like he's up to no good, and there's something peculiar about this guy. Wonder what's up. So as we find out, he tells these guys, "Hey, let me talk to you for a second." We come to find out that this is none other than Xandu, who's going to be the main villain for today. And so what he's going to do is he wants these two guys to work for him. And we wonder why. So these guys are laughing like, "Dude, old man, get out of here. Like, what are you doing?" And so Xandu puts these two big guys, who look like weightlifters, he puts them under a spell. And so he wants them to obey Xandu. And as we see, they're put in a trance. Like, they are dazed. And so we see some of the powers that Xandu has here. He can put people into a spell. And so he performs all these things. Says, "Hey, punch him as hard as you can." And the guy doesn't even feel it. And then he tells the guy in the yellow shirt to punch right through this heavy oak countertop. And he does. And so as you can see, Xandu has this ability to put people in a trance for his own bidding. So he brings these two guys back to his lair, and we've come to find out that the main thing that Xandu wants is the other half of the Wand of Watoom, and he has one half of it. And so what he's trying to get at here is if he can get the other half of the Wand of Watoom, he'll have ultimate power of the mystic arts. And he knows that the other person that has the other half of the Wand of Watoom is none other than Doctor Strange. So he sends both of these guys who are in a trance to Doctor Strange Sanctum Sanctorum so that he can get and retrieve the other half of the Wand of Watoom. So here we have Doctor Strange here, and he's just studying this old ancient scroll, and all of a sudden these two guys just bust into his sanctum, and he's like, "What in the world?" And so he tries to stop these guys, but he tries to put these guys under a spell like Xandu did, but it's not working. He comes to find out that they're under control of someone else. So we see right here some of the powers of Doctor Strange. You saw some of this in the Infinity War movie as well, if you've seen that. A great movie, by the way. Doctor Strange has the power of illusions. He can make things just... He's powerful with all this type of mystic art stuff. It's pretty cool. And I'm glad the movie showed that. So he tries to use different personalities here or different illusions here to distract them, but they still know that this is Doctor Strange because they're guided by Xandu. Xandu's eyes right here, they're guiding these two guys who are in a trance. So they start beating up Doctor Strange and they pretty much defeat him. So Doctor Strange is out cold and Xandu tells them to just start tearing the place apart until you find that other half of the wand, and they come to find it pretty quickly. And so, lo and behold, we see Spider-Man on the scene. He finally catches some burglars here, as we've said, that he's kind of bored and he's looking to just do something at night. So he sees these two guys walking out of Doctor Strange's sectorum, and he's like, "Hey guys, what are you doing?" And then Xandu said, "Spider-Man's trying to stop us. You two need to stop him right now." So that's exactly what these two guys are going to do. Spider-Man puts up a valiant fight, but as we see right here, some great artwork by Steve Ditko, that no punches, nothing can stop these two guys. They're unstoppable. And so Spider-Man is knocked out cold here, as we see right here. And so before these guys can leave, or as they leave, Spider-Man uses one of his spider tracers to track these two guys down so that he can fight them in a round two. And so we see right here the two guys finally give Xandu what he wants. He puts the two pieces together and now he is all powerful. He has the power to basically reach doorways to different dimensions. And he is now the master of mystic arts. As we see right here, he can make different dimensions and it's pretty cool stuff here. He sees that Doctor Strange is still out cold, and so his main threat now, or his main goal, is to destroy Doctor Strange so that he can rule supreme. You'll see right here that by the guidance of Spider-Man's spider tracer, he tracks down these two guys, and he comes to find out that they're under control of this guy named Xandu. So now we're going to see a fight between Xandu and Spider-Man. Spider-Man tries to put up a fight, but Xandu uses his, basically, wand of Wantoom to launch Spider-Man into another dimension. But before Spider-Man is launched into that dimension, Spider-Man knocked that wand right out of his hand and snatches it with his webbing. And so now Xandu is left without the wand of Wantoom. So he tells these two guys to go back and get it. So it's pretty cool stuff. Just some of the imagination that Steve Ditko had here with all this mystic realms and stuff. I mean, it was pretty cool. So Spider-Man has no idea where he's at. He's like, it's going to take more than 15 cents bus ride to get back to Forest Hills in New York. And then these two guys come back. So now Spider-Man's putting up a fight, and he knows now that these two guys are under a spell. So he's putting up a valiant fight here. And finally, we see right here that Doctor Strange comes to his senses, uses his Agamotto to basically search out this ancient amulet, the power of the amulet, to search out the Wand of Wantoom, uses his Cloak of Levitation to fly, and he finally comes to the lair of where Xandu is. So now we see Xandu and Doctor Strange are going to go at it right here, and so pretty cool stuff here. I mean, it's a great team-up book here. So Spider-Man finally comes back. He needs to get back to his own reality. He needs to get back to his own realm. So Doctor Strange here is going to use that distraction to try to defeat Xandu. Xandu grabs a hold of that wand. And so now Spider-Man is back in his own realm. And now Doctor Strange realizes that Xandu has all the power. And so Xandu uses his Wand of Wantoom to try to defeat Doctor Strange, and it looks like he does, but Doctor Strange realizes that if he's going to help Spider-Man, he needs to get out of his physical body, and it says right here, ectoplasmic spirit form. So that's called the astral form. So he's going to use that to go and guide Spider-Man as Spider-Man's fighting these two guys in an alley. Spider-Man is trying to do what he can, but Doctor Strange plants a thought in Spider-Man's mind that, hey, grab a hold of those two wires there. And as these two guys go to finally put their final assault to Spider-Man, they run into these electric wires and it reawakens them. So now they're out of the spell and they're both tired as heck because they've been fighting. And so now Spider-Man goes back to Xandu to try to stop Xandu once and for all. Doctor Strange gets back to his physical body, and now we're going to see the conclusion here with Spider-Man and Doctor Strange teaming up to finally defeat Xandu. And so how do they do it? Well, it takes a bit of a teamwork here. Doctor Strange using his spell, Spider-Man using his webbing. So finally, as we see right here, Spider-Man uses his webbing to web up Xandu's hands, and Xandu is left powerless because he drops the wand. Doctor Strange drains all the power of that wand by using his amulet so that the wand is powerless now. And so Doctor Strange uses a spell in order to drain all of the evil out of Xandu. He uses all of his power to see the backstory of Xandu and how he was a master of the mystic arts. He came across one half of the Wand of Watum, and now he's tried to seize it the other half. And so he puts Xandu under a spell, and by the time Xandu awakes, he will have no evil ambition. And so now Xandu is pretty much left powerless, and he's no threat to Doctor Strange any longer. And so we see Spider-Man and Doctor Strange, they both depart from their ways, but it looks like they are both on good terms. And Doctor Strange promises, now that you have my back, I have your back. And there's a friendship that's pretty much started between Doctor Strange and Spider-Man. So both of them are allies now. So that's how we end this story. I'm glad that y'all got to stick around. If you've already sticked around long enough to see the conclusion of this story, go ahead and give this video a big ol' like. Comment down below what you liked about this story. Again, great artwork by Steve Ditko. Great story from Stan Lee. A little bit different from what we've seen in other videos. But nothing less, I look forward to continuing this series as we look at issue number 29 and we look at the return of the Scorpion. Until then, I'll see y'all then.